Good afternoon, Eagles. I'm Ava.
And I'm Kaylee.
And you're watching this week's episode of Eagle Eye News.
Who's that creeping through my window? Before you come outside, I got the info.
Lake's Got Talent will be this Friday. Make sure to come out and support your fellow Eagles at 7 p.m. in the auditorium.
Tickets will be purchased online. Check your daily announcements for more details.
Hey Ava, are you looking to join track and field this year?
I don't know yet.
Well, just a reminder, Lakes Track and Field has open gym clinics this week. Today is the last day to participate after school in the field house from 3:30 to 4:30.
Class meetings start next week in the auditorium during the study hall period of your lunch.
On Monday, November 13th, juniors will meet A block and seniors will meet B block.
On Tuesday, November 14th, freshmen will meet A block and sophomores will meet B block.
Do you need help studying for an upcoming test or help on a project or paper?
Peer tutors are available on Mondays from 8 to 9 a.m. in the Knowledge Nest on the third floor.
Contact Ms. Bauer with any questions or to set up another time for tutoring if Mondays don't work.
Freshmen, don't forget about your class flag competition.
Make sure to turn in your 4x6 submissions to Ms. Cordova's email by November 21st.
The winner will receive a $10 gift card. Registration is coming up soon.
Make sure you have your classes picked out ahead of time before your counselor meetings.
Freshmen are up first and start next week.
The state of Illinois has implemented a new law in regards to class registrations. Let's talk with Jayvon to get some more information.
With course selection fast approaching, it's imperative that students know what to expect in the coming years. Will this new change unlock untapped educational potential, or will it leave students buckling under the pressure? Let's dive into the Accelerated Placement Act. The Accelerated Placement Act, or APA, is a new state mandate which requires all Illinois public school districts to automatically place students who meet slash exceed in English, math, social studies, or science on state assessments into the next most rigorous level of coursework. State assessments include NWA and PSAT 8, 9, and 10, just to name a few. For example, an 8th grader who scores a 234 on the fall math NWEA will automatically be placed in Math 3 honors, regardless of if they're in an honor class or not. Another example of this is shown on the English section of the PSAT. If a sophomore were to achieve a score of 460, he or she would then be automatically enrolled into AP Lang. But this act does not affect current seniors. The biggest concern for this? Well, it's all in the electives, the fact that our district doesn't have enough teachers to teach these more advanced classes, and the concern that students will pick classes that they're not ready to take. You see, some of these classes require background knowledge and information that isn't taught in a regular class. So by us moving them up, they aren't able to obtain some of that information. The good thing, however, is even though you're automatically enrolled in these classes, you can opt out. So be sure to know which classes you're taking Remember that this is your high school experience. Take the classes you want to take. And with that being said, this is Jayvon Smith with Eagle Eye News. The big concern for this? Well, the biggest concern for this? Well, it's all in the electives. The fact that our district doesn't. All right. For example, an 8th grader who.
What's this?
It's a fruit roll-up. Do you want it?
No.
Well, EEN went around asking people what they would do for a fruit roll-up. What would you do?
Excuse me? Prom or homecoming? Prom. For a fruit roll-up, who's better, Ryan Reynolds or Channing Tatum?
Ryan Reynolds.
No. For a fruit roll-up, say something in a different language other than Spanish.
Bumble class, yeah.
That short, is she a child?
She is actually that short. I have her next hour. I can
confirm. Wrong, she's a child. For a fruit roll up, is Jimmy John's freaky fast?
Sure.
No! Excuse me. What? For a fruit roll up, name 3 of the 7 dwarfs. Go.
For what?
For a fruit roll up. 3 of the 7 dwarfs. Go.
I don't know any dwarfs.
Come on, you're late. Who's better, Channing Tatum or Ryan Reynolds?
Ryan Reynolds.
For a fruit roll-up, what are you listening to? You gotta sing it.
I can't sing it.
You gotta sing it.
It's Can't Take a Joke by Drake.
No, no. Selena or Hailey Bieber, go.
Hailey Bieber, who's that?
Oh no.
Justin Bieber?
Yeah. Yes.
Are they married? Justin Bieber's married?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know.
Okay, so Selena or Hailey?
I don't know who Hailey. What am I?
Selena or Hailey, go.
Selena.
Yes. Thoughts on Drake?
No.
Is Taylor Swift's new relationship real or not?
I don't like Taylor Swift, so I'm going to say she's an L and it's not real.
Correct. Okay. What was Peyton Alaska? Four fruit roll-up named Three of the Seven Dwarfs, go.
What?
Three of the Seven Dwarfs, go.
Humpty Dumpty. Snurpy. Snoopy.
Sleepy
and Doopy. Grumpy.
And then?
Doc.
Yes! Backstreet Boys or One Direction?
I'm old. Backstreet Boys.
Oh my god. Who would win in a fight, Colby or Vishnik?
Definitely Colby.
Yeah, I agree. Lovins!
Hi.
For a fruit roll-up, scream your favorite song.
Wait, what do you mean? Like, scream, sing it?
Scream, sing it, yeah.
But you wouldn't get me hung up on somebody that you used to know!
Here you go.
I'm sick right now.
God.
Sounds like people really wanted those fruit roll-ups.
Yeah, right? Now I kind of want one.
Now let's throw it over to Kylie and Allie with sports.
Hey Eagles, it's Allie.
And I'm Kylie.
And this is sports.
Dollar sign, yeah, I get that. With dollar signs, let's see how far your bars gon' get. Don't do no features, less on you, got no price on this. This double lamb got no OG, just we're beating. But I don't do no beatbox, leave your feet hot. That running like a track star, right out the Reeboxes. No more parties for your shorty, but she still gon' be a. Bet that gon' make it clap to fuck.
The girls' cross-country team placed 7th in state. Bree Gara and Madison Twirling ran PRs and earned all-state with top 25 finishes, while Paige Kruth put together another strong race in the top 50.
Hannah Sabilla, Kate Catalano, and Deeksha Gwaganathan all ran personal best, while Rachel Cowell had one of her best races. This is the 6th time in the last 7 years the girls have finished in the top 10 at state.
In one of the deepest two-way fields ever, the boys' cross-country team finished 16th. Jackson Sami led the way up front. Peyton Whitehead and Brady Mock both set PRs and formed a strong trio with Jackson.
Cooper Sami set a new PR and teamed with Blake Sabilla to round out our scoring. Matthew Poley and Reese Mock both put together one of their best races of the year. Overall, this was the fastest team performance in Lakes history.
Last Saturday, the Lakes Mario Kart team achieved a 5th place finish in the IHSEA Finals. A fantastic showing on Lake's first Mario Kart season. Great job, Eagles.
Be sure to tune in this Wednesday at 5 p.m. on the LCHS YouTube page to see the first game of the Pokemon Unite season as Lakes takes on Oswego.
College commitment season is here.
Miss the signing ceremony? EEN was there.
Our first honoree this morning will be pole vaulting at the University of Colorado at Colorado Springs. That is Miss Josie Gates. Our next honoree will be playing volleyball at the University of Wisconsin, Eau Claire, Katie Mercure. Our next honoree will be playing lacrosse at Mercyhurst University, Sean Ryan. Our next honoree will be playing soccer at Winthrop University, Mia Silver. Our fifth and final honoree this morning will be pole vaulting at the University of Tennessee, Mr. Paul Mygate.
Congratulations to those seniors.
That's all for sports.
Now let's throw it back over to Kaylee and Ava.
Here's for one final announcement. Tomorrow, our Lakes community will have the opportunity to host veterans and dignitaries from all over Lake County.
This is a chance for us to demonstrate our motto, respect plus courtesy equals pride. Not only pride in our school, but also in our country and those who have worked to defend it.
This is an important day for the world, our nation, and the Lakes community to remember that our freedom and liberty have come at a price. It is important that we show our respect to both the veterans present and those who could not be with us.
With that in mind, we ask that all students be mindful of their words and actions during the assembly tomorrow.
And that's
it for this week, Eagles.
Please send announcement requests to EEN at chsd117.org.
If you want more Lake Student Media, visit lakestudentmedia.com or follow us on Twitter at LakeCEN.
And remember, class meetings start next week.
Have a good weekend, Eagles. See you next week.